Hey everyone, hope you guys are all having a good morning. There's Loki. Before we get started, please make sure to subscribe and hit that like button. So, what exactly happened last night and what is my plan going forward? So, there was a series of events, I think, and worries that kind of led to where we are now. The first one was, of course, everybody's a little bit more afraid of what's going to be happening with the Fed, of course. We have the announcement coming out tomorrow if we're going to have a rate cut or not. I doubt we're going to have a rate cut, everybody, but that was one part of it. The second part was technicals since Friday have been pointing to Bitcoin moving further down. And we had talked about that a little bit more. And I'm still going to say this again, just like I said Friday. If you guys are wanting to do swing trades, I would probably hold off unless you guys are trying to buy at a significant level of support. I am not going to go swing trading anymore until I see Bitcoin stabilize, go sideways for a few days, and then have a breakout with all the momentum oscillators on the daily chart at least moving upwards. Not even talking about the 4 hours and the 1 hour and stuff like that. Everything has to be bullish in order for me to really want to buy in again at this point in time. Now, the third thing here was kind of interesting, but at the same time, just crazy when you think about it. If you guys know the exchange BitMEX, I don't know too much about it. It's a smaller exchange for sure, I believe. But somebody went on that exchange and they sold off 850 Bitcoin all at once. That made the price on that particular exchange crash all the way down from $65,000 all the way down to $8,900. Well, you guys know there's a lot of algorithms in trading, and that caused a reaction, let's just say that, which caused a lot of other assets to freak out and such. And people tend to forget this. When Bitcoin has a drastic move down, it really does mess with all of the technicals. So if all the technicals drastically change, it takes a while for everything to adapt. And we are still adapting after that large move down last night. So what am I doing right now? I'm patiently just sitting on my hands. I already bought some with the dip last night, if you guys were live with us, you know, for the midnight streams. I already bought. I'm patiently waiting for another opportunity to buy even more. Let's say if Bitcoin were to dip down below 62,000. Funny enough, one of you guys reminded me that I called $62,000 back on Friday. I totally forgot about that because of all the drastic stuff happening in the market here. But again, I still think Bitcoin is fine for the long term. I am buying right now because I believe the long term is going to be just fine. I'm going to be selling Bitcoin and all these altcoins, you know, in 3 to 4 months, something like that, and I'll have really good returns. Until Bitcoin stabilizes for a few days, though, I don't think this bearish pattern right now that we're kind of in, I don't think it's going to be over. You're going to see a lot more volatility tomorrow when Jerome Powell makes his speech. Hopefully it's bullish activity, not bearish, because if it's bearish, we're probably going to be going back down towards $58,000 next, which will definitely be a very annoying experience for a lot of you guys out there. But overall, I'm still buying. I'm still being patient here. I'm not really trading too much today. I tried a day trade last night. Didn't go my way. But I think even last night, for the people that bought over the 20 moving average, it went up for a minute. Then it got smacked down. There's a lot of manipulation going on right now. So just be careful. And you guys will expect to see me a little bit later on tonight for a two-hour stream. Then later tonight for another two-hour stream. But I probably am going to take a nap because I still am tired. I'm going out to a cigar lounge here pretty soon because a friend invited me. I have to get a box of cigars to him, but I'll see you guys later. And I'm sorry for saying but so much this video. I'm still kind of tired and I don't know how to talk properly. See you guys later.